if you're whether you do spirituality or service, you want success in that also. You want to be successful. Because the very purpose of any human activity, whether it's something small that you do or something large that you do, something very simple, as hitting a ball, you want to be successful. You don't want to do it in a goofy way. Even if you blow your nose and want to throw the tissue into the bin, you want to be successful. I'm saying something so silly. Let's understand what is spiritual process. If you're thinking in terms of spiritual process means you look heavenward, no. This has been cultured. These things we've picked up in the last few centuries, otherwise it did not exist in this country, of looking up, uparwala, doing things. This is a huge problem, which I'm trying to change dramatically now. It's time to bring this guy into account. He's been black, you know, unaccounted man for too long. It is time. My endeavor is to move people from religion to responsibility, because spiritual process means this. What you're referring to as spirit is that which is the basis of your body. When I say that which is the basis of your body, you were not born like this. You came with such a small one and now you become like this. If you put a banana into this, it becomes the same kind of body. If you put a chapati into this, it becomes the same body. So there is an intelligence and a dimension within us which builds you from within. Because of this, now it looks like somebody has to guide you to a spiritual process. If you bring up your children without a single advice, if you're capable of that, it's very difficult, believe me. You know, when my daughter was just 3½ months old, she was traveling with me. One hand on her and my right leg is always full down, and I drove across the country and she grew up like this with me till she's five, till she went to school. Every day we are in a different home, staying with all kinds of people, everybody wants to teach her something. I said, one rule is nobody will teach her anything. No ABC, no 1, 2, 3, no Mary had a little lamb, because I don't care whether Mary had a lamb or not. So you won't believe, nobody taught her anything. By the time she's 18 months, she fluently speaks 3 languages because she's all ears, because nobody talks to her. She just grasps everything around her because nobody is teaching her anything. And she grew up like this, and when she was 12, 13 years of age, one day she came up to me. She just came back from school, disturbed about something there. And she said, you're teaching everybody so many things, you're not telling me anything. I said, well, I don't do anything unsolicited. Here you come now, let's see. So this is all you need to know. So the girl comes to me and says this, then I say, see, this is all you have to know. Never look up to anybody. She looks at me, what about you kind of thing. I said, not even me. Never look up to anybody. Never look down on anybody. This is all the teaching. If you don't look up to anything, if you don't look down on anything, you will see everything just the way it is. If you see everything just the way it is, you will navigate your life effortlessly. That's all it takes. Now, how human am I? You just now use the word human, and almost everybody, everywhere I go, they use the word human, always referring to the limitations of being human, never talking about the immensity of being human. Oh, I'm only human. But why are you not saying, I'm human? You're on top, you're the top species on the planet. You're supposed to be in the top of the pile of all the species. Why people are saying, I'm only human is, because they're suffering themselves like no other creature. Not an ant or an elephant suffers themselves as human beings do. If their stomach is full, they're fine. For a human being, stomach empty, only one problem, stomach full, 100 problems. The reason is, this is an evolutionary thing. It's an evolutionary thing that what you call as your cerebral flower, this brain, is new to you. You know, in the evolutionary scale of things, it is a new happening, this intellect. And most people have not figured how to handle it. They're not suffering the world, they're suffering their own thought and emotion most of the time. Why is it your education systems did not even teach you how to handle your thought, how to handle your emotion? Now, the moment you say you're human or not, first thing, the next question somebody will ask is, can I pull a gold chain from thin air, can I do something else, or can I pull out a rabbit from the vessel, or can I pull a pigeon out of my pocket? If I pull a pigeon out of pocket, my pocket, what will you have? You will have a bird, I'll have a shitty pocket. This is not going to change anybody's lives. I will show you a miracle. I will show you people who are full on activity, not people who are sitting in some cave, full on activity, all right? 20 hours a day, 7 days of the week, we're all on. I'll show you people for 5, 10, 15 years, they've not had a moment of anger, agitation, irritation, nothing, they live joyfully, blissfully. This is the miracle the world wants. This is the miracle the humanity needs. If this happens to you, you will not refer to human as a limitation, you will talk about human as a huge possibility. See, why this has come up is because people have a selective sense of involvement. This is what I said when I said, do not look up to anything, do not look down on anything. This is because if you look up to something, you will exaggerate. If you look down on something, you will exaggerate the negative. The moment you look up to something, you will get attached to it. The moment you look down on something, you will get dejected by it in some way, disgust will come. So these emotions of fear, insecurity, attachment, detachment, everything is a consequence. Shall we handle the source or shall we handle the consequence? People are always busy handling the consequence. They're telling you, trim your fear. Can you fear trim it? No way is it going to work. Now you're flipping on the other side and saying, we need not be ashamed of it, let's have it. Is it a pleasant experience, I'm asking? Is fear, insecurity, guilt, whatever, is it a pleasant experience? If it's a pleasant experience, keep it, it's up to you. If it's an unpleasant experience, is it a choice? I'm asking you just this much. In the world around us, what happens? It's a different issue. World will never happen 100% the way you want it. Even if you're just two people in the family, still it doesn't happen 100% the way you want it. If it's 51% your way, you are the boss, okay? More than that won't happen. But what happens within you must happen your way, isn't it? If what happens within you happened your way, would you keep this blissful or would you keep this fearful or miserable or whatever? You wouldn't do that to yourself, isn't it? At least for yourself, you want the highest level of pleasantness. Though what you want for your neighbor may be debatable, but what you want for yourself is very clear, isn't it?